Hi, I'm Gia Nikolaides with your morning brief on the coronavirus. It's day 53 of the national lockdown and day 18 under level 4 of the regulations. Government is still consulting over the proposal to ease regulations to alert level 3, at least in some areas with lower infection rates. Members of government's advisory council on COVID-19 say they didn't advise for the lockdown to continue for this long. Businesses, some political parties and health experts have called out government on the extended lockdown, saying it's causing more harm than good. At the same time though, South Africa has seen the biggest jump in newly recorded coronavirus infections. 1,160 new cases have been reported in the past 24 hours, and 76% of those are from the Western Cape. The total number of infections now stands at 15,515, and the death toll stands at 264. Basic Education Minister Angie Motshekga will meet again with MECs and heads of departments today to assess whether schools can be classified as ready to reopen after weeks of lost time. Operations at Impala Platinum's Marula mine in Limpopo will remain suspended after 19 miners tested positive. President Cyril Ramaphosa said last week that there would be some changes to the level 4 restrictions. One of them is that you can now buy almost anything online, except of course for alcohol and cigarettes. And while smokers are desperate for the ban on the sale of cigarettes to be lifted, a new study from UCT shows that at least 90% of smokers are still able to get their hands on a packet of cigarettes, which shows government's ban has backfired. Globally, there are over 4.5 million cases of COVID-19. In the UK, the number of people who have died from the virus has risen by 170. This is the lowest increase in the official death toll since March. The death of a pregnant Algerian doctor from COVID-19 after she was denied maternity leave has sparked an uproar and prompted the dismissal of a hospital director. And Madagascar, which has hit the headlines over a homegrown herbal concoction that claims to be a cure for the virus, has recorded its first death. For more on the pandemic, go to ewn.co.za/coronavirus and remember to like, share and subscribe to our YouTube channel.